Wondering if the helper play kit from Love Every is worth it? Today, I'm gonna share all of my thoughts from how my toddler engaged with the items, how long I think they'll last, to how the price of the play kit compares to Amazon and Etsy dupes. All of the Amazon dupes I mentioned in this video are linked in the description box below. If you guys are new here, my name is Rachel from The Confused Millennial. I reviewed all of the Love Every play kits to date. I'll leave a link to that full playlist in the description box below. The Helper play kit is the first in their 2 to 3 year old play kits. So we're in the toddler range now. First is what they call the drop and match dot catchers. My daughter loves this item. I thought it was not going to last super long. Pretty much as soon as I laid it out for her, understood the concept. Red dots, orange dots, yellow dots. I did need to model for her shifting the little slide over, and that was probably the hardest thing for her to master, which took her about 2 or 3 tries. So it was definitely an easy object for her. Despite that, it has held her attention, and she has literally played with it so much over these last few months. The first month alone, she played with it almost every single day. What I love about this item is how it can be reinvented and reimagined for Montessori at-home activities. You can use the wooden dots for early mathematics concepts, from one-to-one correspondence to actually showing how a number symbol is represented with real-life items. It's a fantastic item just to have in the home as your child continues to grow. I think we're gonna get some longevity from it. As far as Amazon dupes go, you can get some similar-ish items for about $13. None of them are quite like Love Every's. I found one set on Amazon that did provide 4 different colors to give that color sorting opportunity that Love Every has. However, you're missing out on that fine motor skill and hand-eye coordination of the slide drop. The other con to that one is that it is plastic and the pieces seem kind of small, which could pose a choking hazard. They also make this in wood, which I guess is an improvement, but instead of getting 4 colors, you're only getting 2. So overall, I will say that Love Every's hits this out of the park. The next item is these felt flowers in a row, and my daughter immediately started smelling them. This seems like such a simple item, but I feel like we've barely scratched the surface of what we can do with this. So first of all, obviously there's the pretend play aspect pulling from Waldorf. Love Every is both Montessori and Waldorf inspired. The flowers are just so high quality and beautifully made. The stems are nice and thick, super soft. Obviously we have early math concepts coming into play with the one-to-one correspondence. You hand them one flower goes into one dot. You can't squeeze 2 flowers into one hole. The other thing I love about it is hand-eye coordination and fine motor movements. Comes with this little Velcro wrap here, and all of the flowers came kind of bundled as a bouquet. My daughter was obsessed with understanding how this Velcro wrap worked. Once all of the flowers are inside, it's a pretty tight wrap. She still is actually really working to master closing the Velcro wrap around all of the flowers in the bouquet. I saw one of my friends who also has this play kit. She used it for a spring sensory bin. The other thing that we did recently was I taped up a few different paper towel rolls along our sliding door. You could use your wall using some painter's tape, and this way they could practice placing these into the different wall vases. Lots of different things that you can continue to use these. Again, an item I think will last for a really long time. You can use them in so many different activities, from language skills, sensorial, math skills, to fine motor skills, and she has loved them. As far as finding dupes, nothing quite like it. This is an item that's very unique to Love Every. On Etsy, you can get wool felt flowers. Are kind of like a wire stem, which I'm not sure how that would work for toddlers. These are more of the girth of an adult finger. They're very, very durable. I don't know how the Etsy ones hold up if a toddler were to pull at the leaves. The other type of option I found was on Amazon, little felt ice cream cones. The next item is this double-sided sunny day puzzle. Been looking for a more complicated and challenging puzzle that your toddler will love. This one is it. We had a similar item already from Amazon in the sense that it was more of a free form block puzzle. My daughter like mastered that very quickly. Regular puzzles, she's kind of over them. This one, she's put it together on her own a few times, but I would say she's still really mastering it. It took me a minute, especially because the other side of this puzzle can be arranged a few different ways. So she found a way. I was like, oh wow, I didn't even realize you could do it like that. It's a really excellent opportunity in building resilience, asking for help, troubleshooting, problem solving, hand-eye coordination. When my daughter does tend to get frustrated, she can't get the pieces to fit just right, she will end up stacking them. And I have to say, she has stacked some really cool designs where she's used the sun as the base, this little wooden rod up kind of like this, and then taken this piece here. And I'm like, how did you balance that? She has really just enjoyed figuring out the puzzle. It is literally the first puzzle in almost a year, I would say, that has truly held her attention. It has been a big win for us. As far as Amazon dupes go, they're gonna cost you anywhere from $10 to $17. There's a more moderate option, which is a Tangram puzzle, and that one actually comes in the wooden box, which makes it kind of similar to Love Every's in the sense that they both have a case really for it. And then the third option, which is what I would recommend getting after this, or if your kid is a little bit older, is one of the loose Tangram puzzle sets. Coming at a couple different price points and varying difficulties. And it comes with little flashcards that act as a visual guide for different puzzles you can arrange the pieces into. The next item is the Anywhere Art Kit with tempura paint sticks. And I have to say, I was so skeptical about this item and just the Love Every 2 to 3 year old play kits in general, because these play kits start to offer more activities in them. So these are little paint sticks. It comes with some paper for your child to use and an organic cotton carrier bag that zips up. My whole take is, if I'm spending $120 on a play kit, I want the items to last forever. So the idea that it comes with something that she'll eventually burn through, I won't have anymore. Granted, I will have the carrying case. It kind of like bothered me initially, but then my daughter hit 2, and I have to say, she really has moved away from a love of toys and more into what activities we can set up with those items. I actually think this is a fantastic item in the play kit. I personally never would have bought tempura paint sticks. I have seen friends rave about them. I always just was like, well, we already have paint. Who cares? However, these are really awesome. I will say, my daughter, when we first took them out, immediately started digging her fingers into them. She has also painted her face with them like she's going to a football game. They are so easy to wash off and they're quick dry, which is fantastic. It's something that's so simple to throw in your bag, bring with you to grandparents' house, to bring with you on a quick trip. So even when I do get to the place of needing to replace the tempura paint sticks, I have a carrier now. Like, as skeptical as I was about this item, they have completely converted me into a fan. And it's not just because I get to hang up my daughter's beautiful artwork now. Also helps kind of develop that early pencil grip, learning how to draw a line. They talk about that in the play guide that comes inside of this play kit. So all the play kits come with a little play guide, which is like your Spark Notes version for your child's development at this age. More ways to utilize the items in this play kit and activities to do with your kid during this time. Calling this a huge win. The next item in this play kit are these map it out routine cards. And I have to say, this item is so frustrating and such a disappointment for me personally. So I am a huge fan of map it out routine cards. I used to work with autistic children. I have used routine cards with kids for years. They are fantastic. Kids like to anticipate what's coming next. They like to have some sort of control or say in their day. So if you guys watched my DIY morning board, you saw I created cards where my daughter got to choose what we did for the day. Especially if you have a nonverbal child, delay speech, and just everyday kids, these are so helpful for making those transitional periods of the day easier. So if you're struggling to get your kid down from dinner to bath to brushing teeth to nap. However, the one thing I normally love about Love Every is the fact that they think their items through. They gave me a bag to put all these wooden dots in. They did not think these through. These are too thick to use with a magnet on my fridge. It also didn't give me like a display card book or anything. So I'm left with, when I want to go ahead and lay out a routine, digging through a pile of cards, leaving them out on a countertop where inevitably my toddler or our dog knocks them over and disorganizes them. For me, these are just a half thought out item, which I've never said about Love Every before. And I do really hope that in future, because this is the original version of this play kit, Love Every has been updating previous play kits from the first 2 years. So my guess is sometime in the next year, this play kit will get an update. Make sure to hit that notification and subscribe button, because if and when that happens, I will update the blog post and possibly this video. But right now, I gotta say, these are just frustrating and we have not used them as a result. Instead, the Amazon dupes for this are actually better in my opinion. The cheaper options are gonna be more like flashcard quality. You can get that for general daily activities, or you can make it more specific. If your child is learning how to use the toilet, you can get a detailed step-by-step breakdown, all the things that are supposed to happen in the bathroom. You can always like attach a command hook in your bathroom that's at your child's height, put the little ring right there and let them go through that as a visual reminder and fostering some independence. Going back to the more generalized thing, there's two different packs that I'll link in the description box. One, magnets, so you can stick those somewhere where your child will visually see it. The next level up, they're also magnetic, but that one also comes with a tri-fold binder and you can move that around. Next item in this play kit is Making Muffins, a very Montessori style board book, which also has flaps. My daughter enjoys this book. We've read it a zillion times. It's beautiful. I like that we learn the concept for early math, both of the symbol, the written word, and then also the real life visual component, as well as obviously the real life pictures of real people and real items, no cartoons. The two Amazon dupes that you would need to get in order to recreate this book fully. One is literally a sequencing book about how to make muffins. That's if you want your kid to learn how to make muffins or go through a book that has sequencing like Love Every's. The second book is a counting book that is Montessori inspired graphics. My daughter would have been just as happy with that book and I would have been happier with that book. That book, just like this one, has real photos, shows the concept of the number symbol, the written number word, and then the real life representation of how that ends up coming to life. That's the high level of my thoughts on that. Most parents, it's a fantastic book, but I actually prefer the Amazon dupe. The last item in this play kit is the sustainable sink with bio-based cups and plastics. Like I mentioned earlier, Love Every is really known for their high quality materials. And so this is probably the cleanest toy sink you will find on the market. Amazon dupes for this item are gonna cost you around $25 to $30, depending on the additional features. Have fruits and vegetables for washing. They change colors. Some of them have little racks that you can hang some of the cutlery and utensils on. Ours, I have never set up. I was actually very on the fence about this play kit too, because I knew we were never going to use this item when I got it. I know kids love play sinks. I actually think that 2 years old is kind of late to get one. I know so many moms that got play sinks for their 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 months olds. I feel like most families who want a play sink will probably already have one by the time the child is 2. Granted, all the ones on Amazon are for 3 and up. Keep that in mind, and you always want to supervise your kids when using it. We got a toddler learning tower at 1 year old. I will leave my guide for how to choose one for your family. And it was a game changer for us. We have a unique kitchen sink setup in that we have a chef's faucet. It is a very light water pressure unless you pull it all the way down. Don't mind leaving that on, letting the water run for her when she wants the water on. She can also reach and pull that down thanks to the kitchen helper. So she is very independent in our sink. In following more of a Montessori approach at home, I try not to use items that we could just use our actual home for. That's why we've never opened it. It's very beautiful. It's very minimalist. It's definitely the best looking play sink I've seen out there. Just felt like one more item to clean for me personally, because after each use, you are gonna wanna make sure you drain the water, take the faucet off, you don't take care of the sink, it could end up breaking. And that goes for any play sink. Definitely think you could introduce an item like this earlier. I hope it's something that they actually move out of this in the future. So is Love Every worth it? Financially speaking, if you were to add up all of the Amazon dupes for this, you're looking at anywhere from $125 and $165. So yes, financially, getting the Love Every play kit is a good deal. Do you think that a lot of these items, more than half of the items, are going to last for a really long time? They're super unique to Love Every, and we are definitely happy to have them. Of course, everything's a personal choice for you. There are other ways to kind of get these different skills that I talked about this play kit meeting met in other ways. It does make things a lot easier. I'm a big fan. I will be reviewing their next play kit in the 2 to 3 year range. Hit that notification and subscribe button. In the meantime, feel free to go back and check out my past Love Every play kit reviews or my What is Montessori video. I know I brought up that word throughout this video. If you guys have any questions at all about the play kit, feel free to hit me up on Instagram at the Confused Millennial or drop a comment below.